Hi, my name is Steve Hanney, CEO and co-founder of Aspenify. Welcome to our product overview. In this video, we will provide a brief background on Aspenify, a demo of the various modules contained within our product, along with example use cases. At the end of the video, we will share how you can get into contact with us. Let's get going. 2 years ago, when we founded our company, we could see an emerging global trend challenging the norms of how workers interact. Analysts such as Gartner now call this trend the future of work. Powered by technologies like mobile and cloud computing, people over the next decade will be seeking new ways to work, increasingly focused on distributed and virtual teams. The rate of change is accelerating, requiring faster decision-making powered by data, and an increased level of visibility at all levels of the organization. In addition, workers are shifting away from traditional classrooms to on-the-job training and continuous learning. With this in mind, Aspenify over the past couple of years has been working closely with a select number of customers and partners to bring to market our new and innovative low-code, no-code, cloud-based solution that would allow you to capture your ideas and learnings in the form of best practice playbooks. Apply these playbooks to real-world initiatives and projects in real time, and coordinate across your personalized communities to maximize alignment across your strategic goals and required business outcomes. I'm pleased to say that this new solution was launched at the end of 2019 and is now available for general use. Let's find out more about this solution and dive into our demo. First of all, we see our Conductor module. The Conductor module is the command center for Aspenify. Here we can see everything that is happening across our selected workspace. In this case, the workspace internal playbook library. You can define a workspace as a community of people working on aligned goals and initiatives. For example, you can have a workspace set up for a business partner to collaborate with your team, or another workspace to manage a specific event across employees, partners, and customers combined. A workspace provides a secure domain for people to collaborate and share information. They can rest assured that the information shared within a workspace will not be visible outside unless explicitly stated by the workspace users and administrators themselves. Note that each subscriber to our platform can have one or more workspaces depending on their subscription tier. At the basic tier, it provides two. At the enterprise tier, it's unlimited. The Conductor module dashboard shows relevant information relating to playbooks over here, content, communities, and initiatives. In addition, the center of the dashboard is an event stream, allowing you to see what events are occurring within your community in real time. The dashboard can also be used to easily jump to a relevant information as well. So effectively, if I want to find out what the playbooks are, I can just jump straight to it. If I want to check out the content, I go back to my dashboard and I can see what published content is available. So everything is at your fingertips using this particular dashboard. Within the Conductor, we also manage the community. The community is really a combination of teams over here and users and roles. So in this particular workspace, I have 8 people. I could go up to hundreds, if not thousands of people in a particular workspace if I choose to do so. Likewise, right now I have a single team. I could have hundreds of teams. They can be hierarchically developed. So you can have teams within teams and so on and so forth. Next, we have the Designer module. Here, we can define our playbooks, or we can select from existing playbooks that are either in development, such as these InDesign playbooks, or published. A playbook can be considered as a reusable template containing 3 key elements: what needs to get done, i.e. the activities, what tools are required to get the work done, the content, that could include software and links to web pages as well, and who is going to do it, the roles and responsibilities. Now, when you're building playbooks, you do not necessarily know who will be working on them. And if you share it with other people, those names and those people will change. Example playbooks can be seen in the selection screen. We have a couple here, opening a new restaurant, employment recruitment, an event. Typical playbooks we're developing with our customers today include new introduction of professional services, new products, software or hardware, corporate events, new employee onboarding, to name but a few. So as you define your playbook, you will go into the configurator and you will define specific roles without, at this stage, identifying people's names. Later on, when we move to the Navigator, we will assign these roles to real people. The second part is the ability to define the flow of the playbook. These effectively turn into the columns in the next part of the wizard. Each of these lines represents a phase or a stage of the playbook. These can be done in sequence, following one another, or you can actually drive them in parallel as well, depending on how you set up your dependencies. So once you've defined your playbook flow, you can move to the sequence screen. This effectively is an interactive designer offering drag and drop functionality to allow you to organize your thoughts and build a structured method to your playbook. Typically, each activity is set up in sequence. And to do that, you can define dependencies, such as here, as I select the dependency option, effectively making sure that research local area cannot happen until you've studied your options. In addition, each activity is provided with its own set of resources, everything from the roles that need to work on the activity, any of the dependencies, as well as reference information. Reference information can be set up using our content management module. This is effectively where you can preload specific content, websites, application links, and so on and so forth. So all you have to do now is just pick up the particular object, in this case menu, and you can drop it straight into your activity. So now when somebody's working on study options, all they need to do is click on this link and they can get access immediately to the menu. Documents, files, websites, videos, applications can all be referenced using this mechanism. So once you've entered all of your activities to make sure it's consistent, you can then move to the publish step. To publish your playbook, you just review the content, make sure your picture is good, and then publish. Moving on from the designer module is the Navigator itself. Here you can select any of the completed playbooks, the published playbooks, and launch your own projects from that. I have a few examples of running playbooks right here. A couple of them around onboarding and welcoming people to the Aspenify platform. To actually launch a new project or initiative, I just select the plus button, select the particular playbook that I want to use, move to the next screen, and then start the wizard. In this particular case, we're opening a new restaurant in Santa Cruz. We're going to set a particular picture right here, and it's going to be this one. And now we can assign it to a team. This team is set up with real people, myself, Erica, Martin, and Jack. So now, as I mentioned earlier, the roles can be assigned directly to those people in a very simple manner. First, you assign the roles over, then you select the person that's going to be responsible for that piece of work. So in this particular case, these are all the various roles required to set up a restaurant. And as I go down the list, I'm just alternating who's assigned for the demonstration. Normally you would see a specific individual's name for each of these roles. Then you hit the next button, and now you're in a stage of the wizard focused on activities. Here you can review the duration, check the activities, make any changes, move them around, add new activities, whatever you need to do. And then when you're good, you can hit next and then go to your schedule. In this particular playbook, the start date is March the 10th, and we're going to add around 10 days of contingency. This also will generate a timeline for you. We then hit next, and now we're ready to launch the project. So effectively, by using the playbook approach, we have gone from starting the process of launching this project to actually kicking it off within a few minutes. And normally this would take hours, if not days, to complete for a new project manager. Whereas with the playbooks, you can actually get that done in near real time. You know, as soon as you know there's a particular job or requirement that needs to be executed, you can do that now using playbooks in a matter of minutes. So we kick off the initiative, and that moves us to the second part of the Navigator, where I can now begin executing the initiative based on the playbook. So I just start these various activities, and I'm now able to monitor the progress as a collective team. So everybody that's working on this initiative together will see the changes as I'm working on them. Equally, if I have an issue within a particular activity, that issue. And now everyone else is alerted that that activity has an issue, and they can jump in and help the various team members. This particular view is called a Kanban view. It just gives you your list of work that needs to be done, what's in progress, where the issues are, and what's being completed. Equally though, if this isn't what you're familiar with, you may want to see it as a sequence. So now you can see it as it relates to the method that you defined in the playbook. And equally, I can make changes and update this in real time as well. All this brings us back to the Conductor module, where you can see in real time the status of the various initiatives. And as issues occur, you will see that flagged right here. So if you want to go back and find out which particular initiative has an issue, you can jump back to it, and then you can see the specific activity. So I can see now across all of the various projects and programs that I'm responsible for and manage it at the dashboard level, as opposed to having to dive in and monitor each individual project by itself. That just about wraps up the demo of Aspenify. Before I go, I'd like to give you a heads up on our new 1.1 release due out in April. In this release, we'll be adding new features such as file attachments with drag and drop directly from your desktop, enhanced community management, and a brand new mobile application available for both Apple and Android devices. So that brings us to the end of our video. Thank you so much for taking the time to walk through our product with us. We're excited to be working with our amazing customers and partners, and welcome all feedback from our community. Feel free to reach out to us via our website at www.aspenify.com, our LinkedIn page, and through our Twitter account at Aspenify Inc. If you're interested in a demo or wish to try out Aspenify for yourself, you can sign up at our website or contact us at info@aspenify.com. Thanks again, and have a wonderful day.